Hi friends, welcome all to my YouTube channel. If you are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. Today I am going to present the topic futuristic curriculum. So it's a curriculum for future. Now let us see the details of futuristic curriculum. First of all, let us see the meaning and concept. Futuristic literally means that it's a design using modern technology. So a design of curriculum as well as education for future by using latest modern technology. Then a futuristic curriculum can be defined as a curriculum which is having clear vision and definition of nature of learners, type of knowledge in demand, diversities in learning process by using tools of modern technology with multicultural and inclusive concerns. So this is a definition for futuristic education curriculum. The curriculum which is having a clear vision and definition. So the curriculum should have a proper vision and definition about the nature of learners, nature of future learners, the type of knowledge which may be required or which may be demanded by future. Then the diversities in learning process with the backdrop of modern technology. What all new learning processes, new learning experiences can be incorporated, as well as in a context of multicultural and inclusive in nature. So that can be a definition for futuristic curriculum. Now there are certain fundamental questions when we are talking about futuristic curriculum. So let us see those questions, and these questions will guide us through the process of developing a futuristic curriculum. So first question: what will be the nature of futuristic education? So that's the first question regarding the nature of futuristic curriculum. What will be the nature of this futuristic education? How the education will look like? That's a first question. So what knowledge is required for futuristic education? That's the other second question. So what should be the nature, and then the type of knowledge required, or the type of knowledge demanded for futuristic education or tomorrow's education? What kind of knowledge or what type of knowledge will be in demand? That's a big question. Then which types of experiences are required for futuristic education? So the type of experiences, type of learning experiences, as well as the type of learning resources, etc., shall be another question for when we are planning to design a futuristic curriculum. What will be the nature of futuristic curriculum? That's the another question. The first three questions regarding education in total, and now the question is what will be the nature of futuristic curriculum, how this curriculum will look like, or is there will be a physical curriculum as we talk about in the case of many other models of curriculum. Is it there is a document such as a physical document curriculum, or there will be a lucid curriculum or a more soft curriculum, whatever. So what will be the nature of curriculum? Then the role of teachers. What roles that teachers have to play in futuristic classroom? That also the nature of schools. The roles of schools, also roles of teachers in classrooms or schools also may dramatically changes. So it is essential to define the role of teachers in futuristic classrooms. So that's another question. Then what to evaluate and ways and means of doing it. So that is probably the last question for almost all models of curriculum in common regarding evaluation. So what to evaluate? That also is the conventional knowledge or conventional learning. Conventional learning process all might have been changed in a futuristic education. So naturally what to evaluate will be a big question, and what will be the tools and techniques we can propose for assessment. So these are the fundamental questions regarding the design of a futuristic, or when we are planning for a futuristic curriculum. So the questions regarding nature of education, the type of knowledge, experiences, then regarding curriculum, the role of teachers, as well as on evaluation. Now let us see background of futuristic curriculum. So why this futuristic curriculum, the concept of curriculum emerges, or what all things, what are elements which support the proposal for a futuristic curriculum? The first element or first factor is existing curriculum. So already we have curriculum for different programs and various institutions in all nations. We have curriculum different types or different nature. So existing curriculum itself act as a strong background for a futuristic curriculum. Then current priorities and concerns. What are our priorities for the day? Today what priorities we are concerning in today's curriculum? So on the basis of that, that will be the basis for future projections regarding a future curriculum. Then explore possibilities of future. That's another background. We have to explore the possibilities of future from looking from the present, as well as the most desirable possibilities. There can be so many possibilities, and among those possibilities, which of them are more desirable? So such desirable possibilities. Then environmental elements, changes in the environment. You know, it's a time in which we all the world is passing through some environmental pressures. So the environmental elements naturally act as a background feature aspect of a futuristic curriculum. Then principle of sustainability, that's another aspect. The sustainability principle, the development should be in such a fashion that it should sustain the life conditions in a better way on earth. So that sustainability principle also is a background for this futuristic curriculum. Then the shift from teaching to learning. So traditionally to the recent times, the focus is mainly on teacher and teaching. And now this is gradually changing to learning and learner. So from a teaching situation, completely teaching situation is transformed, teaching learning, and now towards a fully learner and learning scenario. So a major shift in the field of education, that is a role change of shifting of role from teachers to learners. Learners are required to, or learners are responsible to take initiative in learning process. So that's another aspect. And various curriculum theories, and there are different approaches and theories for curriculum, different types of curriculum. I have discussed different kinds of theories in different other presentation. You can watch that. So these are some background aspects for a futuristic curriculum. The existing curriculum, current priorities and concerns, explore the desirable possibilities of future, environmental elements, principle of sustainability, shift from teaching to learning, and curriculum theories. Now let us see the details about which theory and how these curriculum theories influence a futuristic curriculum as well as futuristic education. The existing curriculum theories. So the first standardized theory is that of Taylor. We have discussed in detail in another presentation. So then theory of Taba, Wilson, Bondi, and there are various other theories, latest postulations also. So the existing theories provide a strong support or a solid foundation for futuristic theory. The theory of Taylor and Taba, all models and theories, approaches to curriculum were were laid foundation on theories of Taylor and Taba, because both these theories are theoretically solid and sound. So on which the further extension we can see in other models and other approaches to curriculum. The concept of the concept that curriculum development is an ongoing process or a continuous process, as well as it is not a linear process. That's another concept, that's a main deviation from that of the traditional theories of Taylor and Taba. The curriculum development is an ongoing, a continuous process, as well as it is not a linear process. So that's some latest theories suggest that it should, especially that theory of Wilson Bondi, we can see that it's the need assessment that should require years of time to complete, because it's a regular or routine activity. Then learner needs over teacher priorities. That also is a major change or from the which taken from latest postulations on curriculum, such as learner needs is more important, or learner needs itself is important than teacher priorities. So traditionally we are teachers determine what to teach or what students should learn. So that should be changed. That convention, that tradition should be changed to the needs of the learner. And the role of the teacher should be shifted to engaging environment. The duty of teacher is to provide an engaging environment to learners. The environment created by teachers, the stage created by teacher to engage learners in the learning process. So that's another aspect. Then which approach preferable for particular persons, for particular reasons at particular times are relevant. So that's another support from, or another proposal should be considered in a futuristic curriculum. The approach preferable for particular person, for particular reason, for particular time. So the curriculum shall be a very fluid as well as dynamic aspect rather than a mere written document. So that's another important consideration for a futuristic curriculum. And the approach preferable for specific person. So there shall be provision in curriculum suitable for each individual, for each situation, for different times, etc. Then individual, society and subject matter as focal points. So for curriculum development, these three elements are the focal points: individual, society and subject matter. Both all these three elements were highly significant when we planned for a curriculum. Then the Eisner's approach, artistic approach, as well as connoisseurship model, that also Eisner put forward so many revolutionary changes in education as well as in curriculum. And his theory, his approach to education, which is artistic approach, and that also influence or that also provide adequate theoretical support to futuristic curriculum. So the existing theories, the nature of or line of curriculum development, learner needs, the characteristic of an engaging environment, then a very flexible nature of curriculum, which shall be suitable for each individual at different times. Then the focal points such as individual, society and subject matter, etc., are the supporting elements from various theories to futuristic curriculum. Now, let us see in detail Eisner's view on curriculum. The curriculum should develop by a collaborative team. That's his first proposal. Curriculum is not a single person activity. It should be developed by a very large team of people, and in a collaborative manner. Then while we design curriculum, social realities are negotiated in a curriculum. So it should be grounded on social realities. What are the real social realities? Not the realities perceived by one group of people. Not like that. It should be based on the negotiation between the major stakeholders at various levels, such as administrators, experts, parents, teachers, students, etc. So all those people shall be engaged in this process, as well as it should be constructive and multiple. And the nature of curriculum, it should promote constructive learning, as well as it should provide multiple needs of individual learners having different capacities, different abilities and different backgrounds. So that's another view of Eisner regarding curriculum. Then he also stressed significance on null curriculum. The null curriculum, you know that schools usually do not teach. That is the null curriculum. And he always say that what we do not teach is similarly important than what we teach. So there are things we the schools miss out, or schools provide stress on certain things only. They minimalize many things, or the school neglect many things. So those things are also are highly important. Usually when we teachers teaching, we search students these and these topics are important, and that convey a message that other topics are not important. So for certain teachers all topics are important. So there is various disparities in this teaching learning process. So what we omit from the school experience or classroom experience, that contribute to the null curriculum. So we so that's also is highly significant. He said that schools ignore or minimalize visual, auditory and metaphoric ways of knowledge. So that's another aspect of Eisner's view on curriculum, that school ignore or minimalize visual, auditory and metaphoric ways of knowing. So schools restrict the ways of knowing by students by a very to a very few or a few or narrow sense. They do not allow students to broaden their learning using maximum opportunities through visual, auditory and metaphoric and other ways or other type of experiences or resources. So for schools, teaching or learning is only a matter of time. It's a timetable work. So it should not be like that. That's his important view. Then students' abilities should be taken into account. He also stressed that the abilities of students should be taken into consideration while designing a curriculum. Now let us see the essential features of a futuristic curriculum. So we have discussed the background, the theoretical support, etc. for a futuristic curriculum. So now let us see what are the essential features. Curriculum development should meet needs of individuals, society's needs for learned people, workers, parents, voters, etc. and subject matter. So three focal points we already seen, that individual, society and subject matter. So the curriculum development should meet needs of individuals, needs of society and subject matter. So needs of individuals as well as needs of society. Society require learned people. So learned people including workers, parents, voters, etc. So that's the need of the society to have people who are learned. That should be an essential feature of a futuristic curriculum. Then it should be student-centered, vocationally oriented and socially reconstructed. So that's the another features of a futuristic curriculum. Student-centered as well as oriented towards vocations, and it should be capable of social reconstruction. Then economic growth and knowledge economy, it should support, the futuristic curriculum should support economic growth as well as knowledge based economy. Knowledge is an essential fuel for today's and tomorrow's economy. So the futuristic curriculum should support this knowledge economy as well as economic growth of the nation. The new human capital is not only to know, but to know how and apply this know-how in new and different contexts. That's another strong point for a futuristic curriculum. A mere knowledge is not enough, but a knowledge of how to do things should be very critical. And what is more critical is to apply this know-how to appropriate situations or in new situations. Then creative skills, problem solving skills, entrepreneurial skills are the few essential skills required in addition to other skills. Other skills also required, but these skills are given prominence in curriculum, such as creative skills, problem solving skills, as well as entrepreneurial skills. Then the other essential features, such as curriculum consonance between goals, instruction and learning. There should be a consonance between goals, instruction and learning. That's another important. Otherwise, goal will remain as such. Instruction will go in other ways and students will learn something else. So there should be a consensus between goals, instruction and learning is another important. It also mentioned in other way as intended, actualized and experiences. So what is intended through a curriculum and what is actually provided or acquired, provided and what actually acquired or experienced by learners. So decision about what to teach should be based on its perceived classroom effectiveness, variations in classroom practices, what students' experience should be as intended. So these three levels or three aspects are highly significant with respect to a futuristic curriculum. So what actually perceived as the effectiveness of classroom, effectiveness in classroom. So there shall be variations in classroom practices. Thus that variations occur in classroom practices, even though the same teacher handle classes, there can be variations. Then what students experience should be those intended as goals of education. So the link between goals, instruction and learning should be properly established. So these are the essential features for a futuristic curriculum. Now let us see few steps for developing a futuristic curriculum. The first one is not as a linear order. These are few steps. We can rearrange it, or we have to consider which we have to decide according to our need to which we should do as a first step. So whatever it is, the basic step or the first step shall be local needs assessment. So needs assessment, the especially for futuristic curriculum, it is advocated that local needs assessment shall be an important step. Then review of curriculum standards. We have existing curriculum and we have to review the standards of that curriculum. Then only we have to find out where we are standing now and what all changes are required. So reviewing that standards, and we have to set certain specific standards and move towards that. Then identification of multicultural competencies. So the world of tomorrow or the future we have to incorporate various cultures, and it is very essential. Multi languages, multicultural communities are prevalent. So that competence we have to develop in learners. So which are those competencies that we have to identify for developing a futuristic curriculum? Then exposure trip to local community, that's another step. Then in order to get a real experience regarding the needs of community, the aspirations of community, characteristics of the community, there shall be an exposure activity within the community. That's essential for that's considered as an essential step in designing a curriculum for future. Then identification of multicultural content. So we have already talked about multicultural competencies. The content we propose to include in the curriculum also should be multicultural in nature, so that significant multicultural content should be identified. Then there shall be another step as meeting with a reference group for the various stakeholders we talk about in almost all kind of curriculum models. So that also is a step, discussion or consultation with various stakeholders as well as other important experts or relevant people for designing a curriculum. Then identification of pedagogy and assessment strategies, that's another important step. Which pedagogy and what procedure we follow for assessment, and what will be the nature of assessment? So how we can integrate the assessment with the instruction itself, and assessment tailored learning. So identification of proper methodology for learning as well as assessment. Then making syllabus and critiquing, the formulation of syllabus as well as its critiquing, its finalization by negotiation, etc. Then presentation to general faculty. So this while going through all the different steps, we will design or develop a curriculum, and that should be presented to general faculty for its critiquing or its final formulation. So these are some essential steps for a futuristic curriculum, beginning with local needs assessment, review of standards, identification of multicultural competencies, exposure trip to local community, identification of multicultural content, meeting with a reference group, identification of pedagogy and assessment strategies, syllabus making and critiquing, presentation to general faculty. So these are the steps for a futuristic curriculum, steps we can incorporate while designing a futuristic curriculum. So that's all about a futuristic curriculum model, and we are moving towards a future, and the future citizens should be capable of doing something better, more creative, more capable of problem solving, must be socially reconstructive capacities. So that's all for the day. Thanks for watching.